Hey, this is Mike. Thank you so much for choosing this video. Today I'm in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, visiting East Coast Volkswagen, and I'm checking out a 2017 Volkswagen Beetle Dune convertible. Fantastic little vehicle, and this one happens to be in a really interesting color, sandstorm yellow metallic. So let's go ahead and check it out. This Beetle is sitting on 235, 45, R18 Bridgestone tires wrapped around a really sporty 18-inch alloy wheel with a two-tone black and alloy popping through there in the silver color. It also has four-wheel disc brakes with ventilated disc brakes in the front and solid disc brakes in the back. The name of this color is Sandstorm Yellow Metallic, and it really catches your eye. Just out here filming, a few people have stopped by and pulled up and wanted to check out this vehicle just because it caught their eye as soon as they pulled into the dealership lot. So you can see it has a very distinct look with the Dune package. Really nice. And the 17 model, I like those wheels and everything about it. I like a vehicle that stands out and gets your attention. All right, so the headlights are the traditional round shape for the Beetle style, and they're powered by halogen bulbs in a reflector housing for your low and your high beams. You also have the same for your fog lights at the bottom. This is what the key looks like, and this one is actually a proximity key system. It does have some useful buttons, the lock and unlock, ability to unlock the trunk, and it has a little switchblade key in case you need to use the physical key, but generally it's designed to where you can just put it in your pocket and use the vehicle 100%. So walking up to the car, as long as you have the key nearby, it can be in your pocket or a bag or whatever. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in my pocket, and I can lock the doors by placing my finger here on a little sensor right here on the door. It locks the door. And then to unlock it, you simply, as long as the key is nearby the door, you put your hand behind the handle, it senses your hand position, it senses the key in a close proximity of the door, and it unlocks the door for you. All right, so you can see that awesome color is also extended in the inside of the vehicle, there on the doors, as well as the dashboard, and even the yellow piping here on the seats, and the stitching and all that good stuff. So taking a look here on the passenger door, now it's not soft to the touch up here because we have the plastic painted here, but it does get into your soft touch surfaces down in here, and especially here on your armrest. Then you have an elastic for a bottle holder and some storage area. Get in the vehicle and put your, I assume you'd be able to put your cell phone. It does have a little bit of a lip here at the bottom to keep your whatever you put in there from falling out. So it's not just the strap, it does have some support there at the bottom. It has the Fender sound system, which is pretty neat. Also has a subwoofer in the trunk, which I'll show you. There's the threshold with the aluminum sill plate. And look how wide the door opening is. With the two-door vehicles, typically get a wider entrance here for the front passengers, or the front occupants, I should say. So it has a manually adjusted seat. It also has the ability to raise and lower the seat using this button right here, or this lever, so you can kind of move it up and down to get the position that you want. You also have lumbar adjustment right here manually, here for the driver and the passenger. And to access the passenger space in the back, you just move the seat forward like so, using that lever. You see the back of the front seat has a little storage pocket there. Just to give you an idea, when the front seat's all the way back, you're very limited on the legroom for the back passenger. So you will have to compromise a little bit for the front passenger's legroom. Now, this seat is all the way back. I mean, it's too far back for me to drive the vehicle and I'm 6 feet tall. So just to give you an idea there. And there's the back seats. Now it's basically a bench seat. It's all connected, but it does have a dished out portion with some bolstering to kind of simulate bucket seats. Yes, a little bit of an armrest there. It does have the latch system or ISOFIX for car seats. 12 volt power supply and a little cup holder there. And it's in a position where the front passengers can utilize that as well as the rear. If you need add a little bit of space to your cargo in the trunk, you can fold the seats down in a 50-50 split fashion. Now, of course, you'll need some room for the headrest, so it depends on the front seat position. But you can add a little bit of space there. There's a little bit of a pass-through in case you need it. But now the seats are not going to recline or anything like that, but they will be more of a kind of straight-up position there. And looking at the convertible top, you can see it kind of folds up into this space here, and it doesn't take up your trunk space. Now, some convertibles, it'll, you know, kind of fold up into the trunk space, but this one does not have that issue. The trunk space is the same either way, basically. To fold the seats down, you will have to use this little levers there on the side, next to the little bag holder there, to release them, and then you can go ahead and push them down. Now, under this cover, there's like a cover here, and there's a spare tire with tools under, in case you need to use that. But for a convertible, the trunk space is pretty significant. All right, so let's go ahead and close that up so we can take a look at the back of the vehicle with a little spoiler there. It's pretty cool, and it has a third brake light in it as well. LED tail lights. And it has the park pilot with the sensors around the vehicle, so it helps with parking the vehicle and kind of beeps at you, lets you know if you're getting close to something. Of course, it has the backup camera as well. Now, the backup camera is in here. This is also how you open up the trunk. So you push that and it releases it and you can lift it up. So you can't see the camera, it's still hidden, but when you put it in reverse, it will kind of pop out and reveal itself, which is pretty neat. You have two exhaust pipes sticking out the back, giving it a sporty look. The fuel door is on the passenger side and it's lockable. So right now it's locked up. It's locked because I have the vehicle locked. When you unlock the vehicle, it will automatically unlock this as well as the doors. So you can open it up and it has a pretty traditional cap with a little tether system, but it has this little post that you can basically put the cap up here right there, so that way it's completely out of the way and it keeps it from losing your cap. It doesn't dangle down, scratch your paint, and I thought that was a pretty neat idea. Another useful feature about this vehicle, if you unlock the door, if you don't enter the vehicle, then it will automatically lock after about 30 seconds or so. So if you accidentally hit the unlock button on your key fob as you're walking away or whatever, it's gonna relock after about 30 seconds anyway, so that way your vehicle doesn't remain unlocked the whole time. To start it up, all you need is the key inside the vehicle. It can be in your pocket or a bag or just in the cup holder like I have it right now. And you put your foot on the brake and push this button right here and it'll start up. Here's the floorboard in front of the driver's seat, and the floor mat's actually covered in plastic right now. It says it's a new vehicle, but it does have a floor mat that hooks in place in two places. And you can see the accelerator and brake pedal, and the accelerator actually pivots at the bottom to keep it, it's kind of a safety issue to keep things from sliding underneath it. Then you have your large footrest here on the left side. And we're gonna look under the hood, but before I open the hood, I wanna show you that when you close this door, it covers up the latch to keep that latch from being open when the vehicle's, driving down the road or whatever. But here's the latch right here. Let's go ahead and release it. To open the hood, there's a little latch right here in the very center. Just kind of reach in, move it to the right, and lift up. And it's not very heavy to lift it up. You see right here is what it looks like. All right, it does require a prop, so you can hold the hood up there. Okay, so TSI, turbocharged stratified injection. So this is a direct injection, turbocharged 1.8 liter, four cylinder engine. It gets 170 horsepower. You can see the insulation there on the firewall. is all the way across. It also has the heat shield as well. The front strut towers are braced in with the unibody structure. It also has an insulated battery. Your intake is there in the front, and the exhaust and the little turbocharger is there in the back. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, taking a look in the inside of the driver's side door, it's just like the other side, except for it has a few more buttons. So the power windows are right here, and it's one touch up and down. Give you an idea of how far it goes or how fast it goes. And the rear glass is one touch up, one touch down. It's pretty cool. And they'll automatically go down when you lower the top. And your door lock controls, and then your side mirrors are adjusted here. They're heated side mirrors, by the way. All right, there's your sill plate there and your threshold. Manually adjusted seat, just like the passenger. So both are the same, basically. So right in here, got this pretty large storage pocket that opens up. Interior gauges, the dimmer switch is here. You can also turn your interior lights on, and there's your headlight controls. So you have an automatic headlight and an on for your headlights, and then you pull it out for your fog light. You also have a tilt and a telescoping steering column. You just release it there, and then you can go up and down, in and out, get it right where you want it, and then you lock it in place. Okay, let's take a look here on the inside and check it out from the driver's seat. Now, let's go ahead and close the convertible top. I have the shade over the windshield here to kind of reduce the glare, but of course some light coming in the top. So to do that, it's very simple. There's a button right up under here, and just hold it. And it kind of beeps at you, let you know it's done. But if you keep holding it, it'll go ahead and roll the windows up for you. All right, so then it kind of ramped up the climate control for me now, since the doors and windows and everything shut. All right, so let's go ahead and start here on the steering wheel. Now you notice it has the flat bottom steering wheel with the Dune name there at the very bottom. Looking all awesome. It also has the contrast stitching. Another thing that looks awesome. Slight bolsters here on the top. Leather wrap steering wheel, by the way. Now the seats are a combination of cloth and leatherette, so this is a synthetic leather material. Okay, on the left side of the steering wheel, you have your volume for your radio. You can send and receive phone calls by using the phone button, and then you can change your presets on your radio here, or your audio tracks, depending on what you have going. And then you have your voice recognition button down here. Here on the right side, these go through different menu systems. Here on the center screen, which we'll get to in just a minute, there's a back button. So there's some little controls there for your screen. So here is your windshield wiper controls. On the right side, your turn signal is over here, but it also has your cruise control. So you can off, and then you have on, and then you have a cancel right here when you just kind of bump it. You can set it, resume, and you know, like go faster or slower right in here. Okay, looking at the gauge cluster here, very simple. It has a big speedometer in the background. You notice it has the yellow dials around the outside, looking nice, kind of matching the rest of the vehicle. So your RPMs are there on the left, and the center is your speedometer, nice big speedometer. On the right is a fuel gauge. Everything's big, easy to read. It has the large letters and the flat black surface in the back, and it's kind of recessed in there quite a ways, so that way it kind of, it's easier on your eyes to refocus from the road to the gauges here. Then you have has like a small screen That kind of gives you some more information. So has your outside temperature, the clock, but using these buttons right here, we can kind of cycle through and get some more information. You can go into your settings, you can see your range, audio, basically what your radio is doing there. So scrolling down, you can get some more information here. So scrolling down, we have your distance, your odometer, average speed during that time period. You also have a digital speedometer, which is handy. Oil temperature, coolant temperature. You can set a speed warning, so it'll beep at you if you go too fast or higher than a speed that you set. Travel time, consumption as far as your miles per gallon, average consumption, and then it goes back to your range. So I think the digital speedometer would be my default position there. I would like to have that up. But just kind of give you an idea. You don't have to go into all that information if you don't want. It's just there in case you want to check it out. All right, love that dashboard. That continuation of that yellow color is really nice. And you have like a storage pocket there in the center, just a kind of quick access or a quick place to put your sunglasses or just something to set down. Okay, so here's your touch screen, and it has like a little gesture sensor here. So as you put your hand up to touch the touch screen, these little options pop up right here. And then it has some buttons on the ends, so you can change the different AM, FM on your radio. And then you can go into your radio, your media source. So there's lots of different ways of playing music through the sound system. You have your audio input, USB, and of course the Bluetooth wirelessly, so you can play music off of your phone. And speaking of phone, let's go to the next one. Once you pair your phone, you'll be able to send and receive calls. You'll have access to your phone book and all that good stuff. Then your voice recognition is here. It also has an SD card reader, so you can play stuff off of that. You can eject. It does have a CD player up in here. You can mute, you can adjust the sound. Then you have a whole menu with all kinds of different options here. All right, then you have a pretty traditional volume tuned through the stations buttons there. Okay, so your climate control is down here. You have a dual zone, so your driver and passenger temperatures are on the ends. And then you have your fan speed in the center. You can sync both your driver and the passenger temperatures if you want. So like right now, they're independent. Let's go ahead and push sync. So now they're the same. If I want to unsync them, I would just go ahead and start adjusting the passenger and it'll unsync those. Let's go ahead and turn the fan down. All right, so you have your parking sensors, which are in the front and the back. You can turn that off if you want to. And then your four-way emergency flashers are here in the center. And right in here is a storage pocket with a little USB and auxiliary input. So you can plug your cell phone in, charge it, play music off of it, that kind of stuff, and have a place to put it down. And this is like a rubber surface here that's removable. You see a little tab, you can pick it up and take it out, clean it, put it back in, that kind of thing. 12-volt power supply. We already saw your push button start. So here's your shifter. Now you can see it has the yellow stitching matching the steering wheel and everywhere else. And let's go ahead and put it in reverse. Now two things will happen when I put it in reverse. First thing is the backup camera will pop up here with the little guidelines there. And the second thing would be your parking sensors. Right there is kind of visual representation as well as your audio. So if something gets close, so let's go ahead and back up and kind of see that. I don't know if you can see my tripod back there. So I'm gonna get close to it. And we're going to hear it beep at us. I don't know if you could hear that. But you can see it gives you a visual representation there in the screen. So you can kind of see where the tripod is. So it was a little bit on the left side. So it lets us know, hey, that's where it's at. So that's where we need to look when we're backing up. All right, so continuing down, there's your normal drive position. Then you have a sport mode, which emphasizes like less fuel economy, more performance. And then you can go over to a manual mode so you can cycle through the six gear ratios manually if you want. So let's go ahead and pull back up a little bit so it won't beep at us anymore. Now, if we need to get close to something and we are we don't want to hear the beeping, we can always turn them off right here. Remember, see, it just it lights up when it's on. Okay, so there's your hand parking brake, your hand brake. And then you have some cup holders here. They're open in the center, so you can utilize that for more than just cups. It does have little articulating arms there to take up the slack for different size cups. And here's an armrest, and it's kind of small, so you're gonna have to tell the passenger to, you're not gonna share it with them, basically. Has a little bit of give to it. It's not super soft, but it's not hard as a rock or anything. Now, this is kind of like a clamshell. The top portion lifts up, and then you have a storage pocket there. It looks like it's perfect size for us, like a cell phone or something. And it does have the little rubber flooring that's removable. And then the whole thing lifts up. Then you have a little storage pocket there, little storage pockets, and then you have full access to your cup holders there. All right, so up here, it has an auto dim rear view mirror, and it's actually auto dimming right now because I have the sensor is covered up with this light, the light sensor is covered up with this the shade, so I'll give you an idea about that. And you have some tap lights. You can turn on all your interior lights on like that, or you can turn it off, or you can put it in the center position and they'll turn on when you open up the door. See the little visors, have a little place to put some stuff, and it has a mirror. Okay, so let's take a look at the visibility in the back. Now you'll notice that the headrests are quite large in the back, so they do obstruct your visibility quite a bit. Now if you put the seats down, then that will help. But you also have a kind of a small window in the convertible as well. So as long as you're aware of it, you're fine. It does have the park pilot, the backup camera, and all that good stuff to help you out with changing lanes and backing up. But still need to be aware of that. All right. Okay, so thank you for watching, and thank you to East Coast Volkswagen here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, for allowing me to show off another awesome vehicle. And hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and more information will be in the description as far as specs, all that good stuff. Just want to give you a visual representation of the vehicle, of how to, you know, how it feels, how it looks, that kind of thing, and then you can get the hard spec numbers if you want to in the description. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.